yeah, that's Scuttlebutt. Well, I was flying over land and sea and ear to the ground. Then I came flying here for you to see and hear what I found. Remember the swamp? Remember my song in the swamp when I was like, wah, chicka, wah, wah, chicka, wah, wah.
I remember.
Wow. Somebody should find that poor animal and put it out of its misery.
Many of you have grown up with this classic red-headed ginger being everyone's favorite Little Mermaid, but thanks to progressivism, we've been able to overhaul legacy characters for today's modern audience, and we've upgraded regular Ariel to Ariel Black. This is the old version.
Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun, wandering free.
And this is the new and improved version. Oh wait, that's what the Little Mermaid will look like 10 years from now. This is the Little Mermaid for today's audience. Yep, I knew I'd get it right. The movie starts off with a bunch of white nationalists attempting to kill what they think is a mermaid, but don't worry, Eric jumps in to stop them and save the day. We then transition into the ocean, and judging by how diverse each of his daughters are, we find out King Triton has banged his way across every culture in the world. Ariel Black isn't there for their meeting of the moon or something like that? I mean, what's the deal? They didn't have the budget to recreate the original musical play in the cartoon? And yes, I did decide before I took one for the team and watched this 2-hour long car wreck, I would go ahead and watch the original for the sake of context. It was gay.
You remember Cinderella? The pumpkin that turns into a coach and the mice that become horses? Dude, could you be more gay?
Ariel Black goes to explore downtown Chicago at night with whoever the hell this is supposed to be. Jaws comes in and attacks them, and there was this slight hope deep within my cold beating heart that if this shark kills and eats both of them, then there's a chance this movie could be good. It probably still wouldn't be after that, but it would at least give it a chance. Sadly, they get away, and spoiler alert, I began to realize that this cheap carbon copy of the original was going to be just that, a shallow copy and paste, almost beat by beat, of the one released way back in 1989. I was so excited at this point that I fell asleep. When I woke up, I saw an angry Mexican playing King Trident destroying all of Ariel's stolen crap. The Blob shows up, you know, that actress from the other remake everyone just loves so much, and she convinces Ariel to go to her grotto. It was about this time I began to realize just how dark this movie is. I mean, just because it's real life doesn't mean you have to make it look so depressing. Have any of you actually seen the coral reef, like in the Red Sea for example? Yeah, me neither, but I've looked at plenty of videos of it online and it's pretty amazing. Just imagine 1,000 unicorns taking a giant shit in the middle of the ocean. I mean, it's the most beautiful thing you'll ever see. This movie looks like something someone would vomit up after eating breakfast at a strip club.
There you go.
A few things happen after all this crap. Too bad I fell asleep again. I did, however, wake up just in time to see the Blob grow to the life-size version of the actress actually playing her, which was followed by Ariel Black crashing the ship into her belly, killing her and saving the day. You know, in the original animated movie, it was Eric who saves Ariel, and not the other way around. I like that. First, Ariel saves Eric from drowning, and then he saves her from Ursula. It really lays the groundwork of what a real relationship is supposed to look like, yeah? Give and take. Sacrifice. Meeting in the middle. Lifting the other person up when they've fallen down and need help. It's subtle, but I feel like the cartoon conveyed that message pretty well. Sure, there's themes like the starry-eyed teenage girl with daddy issues, wanting to leave home and fall in love with a prince, plus all the song and dance and romance that comes with all that, but the heart of the story is that whoever you fall in love with, no matter your differences or your backgrounds, you end up making each other stronger when you learn to depend on each other. Having Ariel Black save Eric at the end of this movie, like she did in the beginning, takes a giant shit all over that. All in a day's work for your feminist BS ideology that says, I don't need no man. And if your response is, well, it's just not made for you. It's made for little girls. It's not made for you. I would like to inform you that in the past few days before watching this movie, I actually started identifying as a gay giraffe whose diarrhea turns to glitter on cloudy days. So the movie is absolutely made for me, bigot. To sum everything up, the movie sucks balls. I know I fell asleep 3 or 4 times while watching it, but it still sucks. And that's not my opinion, it's actually an objective fact. But tell me what you think. Did you watch it and like it? How many times did you fall asleep? If you liked the video, please hit the like button, and if you were offended at anything I said, let me know in the comments so that the rest of us can make fun of you. As always, guys, thanks so much for watching, and have a great freaking day.